In the introduction, we realized that sampling has an effect on the time domain. And I use the following example here. Xn, and that's n, and this so that's time domain xn, so we had a signal where this was your plus one and this was minus one. And if you have a signal like this, we realize this is actually the maximum frequency which can be represented, because we need something like there's a peak and a valley, and with that we are reaching maximum frequency. So this then we realize that we have an effect on the frequency domain. Frequency domain. And there we realize that we have a maximum frequency here. Yeah, so if we are hitting fs half, yeah, so all our frequencies, they have to stay in here. And so we have here the so-called Nyquist frequency. That we have to apply low-pass filters to make sure that our signal stays in this region here. So in the previous clips, I've done this more or less in the hand-waving way to give you a good understanding of that. So next clips, we're doing this properly analytically and deriving all that and coming to proper conclusions there.